attention. Well, the clashes between religious freedom and gay rights have been on the rise in recent years, and the trend may still increase after the Supreme Court's legalization of same-sex marriage. Right now, more than a dozen state legislatures are moving to protect the religious freedom of their citizens. Chuck Holton brings us this look at the work to protect those rights in West Virginia.
West Virginians take their religious liberties and their religious rights very seriously, and they want to see us ensure that those are protected.
It might be snowy outside here in Charleston, West Virginia, but it's heating up inside the state capitol. The state house is taking up a Religious Freedom Restoration Act, similar to the one that caused so much controversy in Indiana in 2015. Tim Armstead is Speaker of the House in West Virginia.
It's not creating a new right. It's not taking away anyone's rights. It's just restating what our Constitution already guarantees and what truly natural laws and God-given rights are in our country.
People of West Virginia have just had enough, and they're reacting to this big government overreach in every area of our lives.
John O'Neill is a former basketball coach who has served in the state legislature since 2011.
We believe that West Virginians should be free to live and work according to their faith without being in danger of being punished by their government.
O'Neill points out the Constitution's language is clear.
It doesn't guarantee anyone's right to not be offended. It doesn't guarantee anyone's right to have any particular kind of lifestyle or behavior protected, but it guarantees the free exercise of religion.
That freedom has been severely curtailed in recent years with the growth of gay rights and mandated contraception coverage under Obamacare, among other things. But these politicians believe the time is right for the Mountain State to push back.
In January of 2011, when I was elected, there were 35 Republican members out of 100, and today there are 64. Without a doubt, most West Virginians are very disappointed in the war on West Virginia jobs and the war on West Virginia values.
O'Neill knows it will be controversial.
Well, I fully expect that there'll be a spirited opposition. This happens any time that people try to stand up for constitutional freedoms and really to take a stand for faith and values issues.
Various groups want the bill to become law and recently came to the Capitol from across the state to show their support.
We definitely have the support of the majority of our members, and I think the overwhelming majority of our members. Then it'll be up to the governor to determine if he's going to sign this bill. He could let it become law without his signature, or he could veto it. And if he chooses to veto the bill, then we'll go to work right away to overturn the veto, because in West Virginia, it only requires a simple majority to override a governor's veto. So we believe if we've got the votes to pass the bill, we've got the votes to override the veto.
21 states now have laws on the books that limit the government's ability to punish people for living out their faith in public. But opponents of these bills say that they provide an avenue for discrimination, and these two contradictory worldviews are not going to be reconciled easily.
We would certainly appreciate the prayers of the people across this country that we will do what's right and show the courage that's needed to take this across the finish line.
From Charleston, West Virginia, I'm Chuck Holton for CBN News.